Hi guys, it's Robert Jones again. I'm back in the kitchen with a little something different today. This is going to be a garnish. You could use this at Christmas, you could use this at Thanksgiving, your special holiday, whatever you want to use it for. We're going to make sugared grapes. Sugared grapes, you say? What are those? Basically, we're going to take grapes, we're going to give them a pasteurized egg wash, we're going to put them in sugar, and they're going to make them sparkly. It's really good as a garnish. You can put it on a cake, you can put it around your turkey, you can put it anywhere you want, and they're also delicious to eat. Kids love these. Give them a try. So the first thing we have to do with our grapes is we need to wash them. I got two different kinds of grapes here. I've got some Concord, which are the really nice dark ones, and I've also got some Red Flame. I believe they're Red Flame. They just call them red seedless grapes. And they're looking like this. So do yourself a favor and wash these well. They get spider webs, they get, I don't know, they get all kinds of stuff. Try to be gentle so they don't fall apart. If you have loose ones, it's okay. Just try to get a nice bunch. Mine are a couple days old, but the fresher the better. Just because I've been trying to do a thousand things here. Now this one is not sexy. Man, I'm gonna use this container. It's got nice holes in it. So here's what you want to do. You want to cut these into manageable size chunks of grapes. So for instance, this is probably a good two or three here. So I'm going to try snipping it in half. And now remember, this is going to be a garnish. So the thing you want to do is get rid of extra stem that you don't need. And anything that looks nasty to you, just take it off. Okay, so that looks pretty good. That's a nice little bunch. And I'm going to set these, I'm setting this back in the thing with a towel to dry them a little bit. So you're going to go through and try to make nice little bunches. These are not cooperating. So a nice little bunch, clean up any nasty stems. This is a labor of beauty and love. This is not a quick item, but it'll be worth it. Just get rid of anything you don't need. Nice little, whoop, dropped them. Nice little bunch of grapes. Don't worry, the ones that don't get selected can still be eaten. They're still delicious. And when we start this process, you will definitely understand why the trimming makes a difference. All right, there you go. There's a nice bunch. Perfect. There's a nice bunch. Now, you don't have to have separate colors. I just wanted two colors just for variety. A friend and I bought a thing each of grapes and split half and half. Nice bunch. Nice two bunches. All right, you guys, here comes the more complex part. So we have our bunches of grapes. Bunches of grapes. I also have a tangerine. We can try that. Here's what we're going to do. We have what's called liquid egg whites. And if you look here, you need to find this because it says pasteurized. Can you guys read that? Pasteurized, which means that they've already been, they killed off the bacteria. Whether it's from heat or chemical, I'm not sure. It says 100% liquid egg whites, pasteurized. The reason you want pasteurized is you don't want to get fooled with salmonella or something else. So we're just going to open this, and then I'm just going to start with about half of it, because I don't know how much we're going to actually need right now. And you can see it's very liquid. It's kind of creepy. And the idea here is pretty easy. We're just going to take the grapes, put them in the eggs, and then put them in sugar. And then I have over here, I just have a baking sheet with a rack on top so that they can get air circulation underneath and they can dry. We also have some treats. If we decide to get crazy, I've got some green sugar. I've got some pink sugar. I've got some large, what they call sanding crystals, which is just sugar with really big crystals. And then I've got some red sugar. I don't know if we're going to get all crazy like that, but we can at least start with white sugar. So, just white sugar. Let's start with two scoops. So we've got our liquid eggs. We just take a bunch of grapes. If I can grab a bunch here. Grab a bunch of grapes, put them in here, and then try to get as much of the liquid off as you can. Let it drip. Put it in the sugar. And in this case, I'm going to use a spoon. And I'm just going to toss the sugar over the grapes. All right. And then shake. Oops, and they're falling apart. And see that? Sugar. And when they dry, they're going to be all crystalline pretty. All crystalline.
And they're going to look like they were in a snowstorm or something. All right, so let's give this a little whoosh. You can do this any way you want. All right, and shake it dry. And into the sugar. And toss, and toss, and sprinkle. Toss and sprinkle. Make some music. A bit more. Try to get the big chunks off. Try to get it out between. Look at that. How nice does that look? All right, let's try this. Never done a tangerine. All right, Tanjo, Reno, rolling around, kind of making a mess. All right, well, he looks a little sugared. Let's see how he does. I don't know, maybe he needs another roll. There we go. Roll. Here's a trick. So do one hand wet, like this, and one hand dry over here. One hand wet, one hand dry. So you're saying, what do I do with all of these sugared fruits? Well, you can stack them on a plate. You can put them around your turkey. You can eat them. You can make friends of the children of the party. There you go. That one looks pretty darn good. All right, I think you get the point. I don't think I need to do this whole bunch. And I'm going to let these dry, and then I'll show you what these are going to look like and how to make a fancy thing. All right, so I thought I'd show you another one of these because I've been working on my technique. So swish it around. This part hasn't changed. Dry it off a little bit. Shake it dry. And then when you put it in the sugar, if you just hold it and sprinkle it over it like this, you get a much nicer... It looks to me... Let's try this again. So can you see it? Just sprinkle it over. Then it looks to me like it actually snowed on the berries. Snowed on the berries. And then we'll set that down. So there's your official technique. Snowed on the berries. All right, we'll do one more. Because now I'm having fun. And the official snowed on the berries look. You know, that's the fun thing about doing projects like this, is you develop a better technique and it gets better looking. Snowed on the berries. Okay, so say you've got your turkey. We're going to make these beautiful apples, our turkey, or whatever we're going to arrange on the plate. Say we've got our thing in the middle here. Or maybe we are just making an arrangement for the table. It doesn't matter. So say this is that. Now, I haven't allowed much time for these to dry yet, so if the sugar flakes on, don't hate me. Just understand the process that when you let these dry for a couple hours, the sugar will harden up. So once you've got your apples or your meat or whatever you're going to make here, you can simply put your sugared berries around nicely. And if you try to put the stems hidden a little bit around here, your sugared berries looking frosty. Sugared berries looking frosty. Maybe here. We could put a nice orange, which is not the nicest thing in the whole world, but it is okay. You get the idea. And put some more sugared berries. Alright, I think you get the point. Look, you can make a really nice arrangement or garnish or whatever you want it to be. Give this a try. What the heck? Make it pretty.
Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. The sugared grapes will be a nice treat for a lot of different people. Give them a try. It's pretty darn easy, and I think people will be impressed when they see this on your plate. If you guys would like to find me on the web, you know where to find me. EudaemoniusMarkII, EudaemoniusMarkII. Thanks for watching, you guys. Take care.